Hi there, this is Sanjay, your senior program manager. This video is for all the project admin out there to improvise your organization and repository by adding your mentor. And I'm going to show you a step-by-step process for how you can add the mentors. Now, if you go to the GitHub discussion, again, the link is there popping, highlighting right now. And you can see the pinned repository over here, right? So you can click over here where you will be able to see a complete hands-on guide for project admins, mentors, and everything. So this has all the perks which we are going to give or any of the details over here. So make sure that you come and watch it. So this video is specifically only the guidelines and how you can add your particular mentors and how you can help them to scale up. All right. And if you have any questions regarding project admins and thing, you can always come back here and raise a new discussion, or you can just go into the new discussion and click on new discussion, and under project admin, I think it's over here, project admins and mentors, you can ask questions directly with the team and they will be answering your questions. So this is how the things is going to be happening in GSOC. This is how you have to answer, ask questions in the GSOC. Now, the second thing is, like, I have seen like most of you following a bad labeling. So the labeling should be like GSOC small letter hyphen extended EXT, then Hacktoberfest accepted. And levels are like, there are three levels which we follow: level one, level two, level three. All of them should be small letter and without spacing. This is, you have to make sure that this has been happening. Otherwise, the points won't count towards the leaderboard and it will create a lot of issues, right? So that's the thing. Now, we have the point system over here. So that's all things which I want to give and highlight. And as you are the top level people, you have a lot of influence on how the program is supposed to be happen. Now, let me show you how you can get your mentors. We already assign you mentors into particular projects. For example, if you go to the mentors list assigned to PA, so this is a list assigned. Now search by your repository. So I'm just showing you one sample repository, Stack Overflow. When you try to search it over here, you can see this has been already here and you can see who is your mentor. So there is like two people and their LinkedIn profile and their GitHub profile as well, right? So first thing, you can go to their profile and see whether how good they are. Again, we wanted to give an opportunity for everyone. If you see that, okay, this person has very less technical knowledge, it's all right. If you request us for a new mentor, we could definitely assign you something, a new mentor who is like highly technical sound or something like that. But I do recommend this entire GSOC program is to help people and scale up people and learn from each other. So this would be an opportunity for these people to learn from and how to do mentorship. And you know, as a project admin, you reach that level because you had learned a lot of things in the way and try to scale up these mentors into a project admin level for the future programs. So this is what your motto should be looks like. Don't just look into their profile and look at their streak. Yay, we have assigned a mentor which is not even really good or technically sound. So yeah, if you have any concerns, I have mentioned you how to ask a question to us. So ask only through the GitHub discussion. Here we can follow a thread and we can find a resolution. And when you reach out to people or ask questions, always try to tag any of the program manager, including me, so I can find a quick resolution for what you're looking for. Now you found this particular person. So what you need to do is like click on their profile. Now go to your organization. For example, I'm just showing you my organization at the moment, just to show you how to get things to be done. Now invite them into our organization. So I made it automated, or you can send an direct link to join your organization if you are part of any organization. Else is fine. Just go to your respective repository, for example, Stack Overflow analysis, and go to your settings. Now go to collaboration and teams. Now you can see there are already people been there. So if you feel like, okay, they've been not triggered or they should not be a part of your team, you can just filter out and click on add people, add this person's name. At the moment, I only give write access to these people. So they have the basic write access. They don't have the merge access of any of the PR. So this is particularly a good way of handling thing. And similar way, you can find the next person. Again, you can see that, okay, this person has been worked on a few of the machine learning repository. So I do believe, okay, they would be useful to me. Right. Again, they are not really technically sound good over here or have a previous experience on managing thing, but you're providing a space for them to improvise. Now go to your repository, which is manage access. Click on add people. Click on invite. Give them a write access. Add them into your repository. Right. Maybe try to create a video like this in the Loom and explain the process, like what exactly they need to do. Now I'm going to explain them like what exactly need to do. For example, so this video is for the mentor who is being part of my program. So what you have to do is like make sure that you understand this particular Stack Overflow analysis. So this is basically a Streamlit application. So what I'm trying to do is like help the mentors to understand, like give an overview about what is your project, which branch you are managing it. So we have multiple branch, test branch, Sanjay, or whatever it is. And this is how the things looks like. And let them know how you want to maintain your repository. Give them feedback about what's your README profile, go through it. Tell them to replicate the repository in their local system and see is there any place where you're lagging or finding confusion in replication. If yes, then you have to push that changes into the README and make it more useful. Now, let them know, let them go through your Streamlit app and see whether it's working or not. Ask them whether is there any space for improvement. If yes, tell them to discuss first with you. For example, they can always start on the discussion with you. This would be a great way of discussion. So for example, unable to add a commit message. So this is one of the issue which mentor has been raised. Try to talk to the particular admin. Then convert this issue from here, create an issue from this discussion. So that issue will be appearing on your repository, right? So when you go to the Stack Overflow issues, that issue will be over here. Or you can directly raise a new issue and tag your project admin and have a discussion whether you should make this change to be available on the website. For example, I don't have any logo over here. Now, a mentor can come here and start a new issue, creating a logo, or maybe have one issue on chat with the project admin on the Discord or LinkedIn or any of the platform. For example, you can find their respective LinkedIn and Discord platform over here. So have a chat with the respective team. So once the chat is been done, what you need to do is raise a new issue. Now, let me see. Need to add logo, right? Now add much more details, like so then they understood what this is all about. Then tag the project admin just like this. Submit the issue. Now, as you been already accepted your invite, you will be able to handle this particular thing, right? So if in case in the future, if any of the contributor comes and raise the issue, you discuss that with the project admin and assign the particular person according to first come first serve basis and assign the labels. Make sure that labels are correct. DSOC, Hacktoberfest, level 1, level 2, level 3 based on what is their level is all about. Now assign the particular person. For example, I can assign Jisha over here because I tagged Jisha to work on this. So it should looks like this. Now, if there is any help for contributor needed, a mentor should be able to assist them. So it might take 1 or 2 weeks to mentor and project admin to understand the overall concept, but mentors are here to help project admin to manage the redundant task. So the project admin only can focus merging the pull requests and improvising their profile. So this is one of the thing which we are looking for. Now on the pull request also, when somebody raise a new pull request, make sure that it has the label of the same label, GSOC extended, Hacktoberfest, level 1 or level 2 or level 3 accordingly. So there should be only one level at a time, either level 1, level 2 or level 3. So this is a few things which you need to focus on. Now, once you add the particular person in your GitHub profile, what you need to do is like their LinkedIn profile is over here. Try to reach them out on the LinkedIn platform. I do recommend to record a session like this in Loom platform or any of the platform which you're using, then reach out to them. Now you can see that, okay, this particular person, I already tried to reach out. I already dropped a mail. So this is one of my another mentor. So I dropped a mail like this. Please watch this video, which summarized the entire similar information, telling them, okay, understand our repository first, then have a 1:1 discussion with me on WhatsApp or LinkedIn. But I tend to do all the discussion to be happen on this particular discussion channel itself, because by this way, it would be way too easy for to understand and follow the thread rather than having a WhatsApp discussion. So try to use more of the discussion, try to create more of the issues, because the more you try to create the similar issue, the more you'll be able to see the streaks on your GitHub. So I do encourage to do the GitHub for all of the tasks and go through it and understand what this project is all about. See any space where you can improvise this project. So these all are the better thing which you can do, right? So there could be a lot of things can be done over here, right? So this is a something which you are trying to, we are trying to enable you to scale up through the mentors, and project admin should follow this thing. It might take some time to connect with the mentors for your project, but make sure that you connect. And if you somehow feel like, okay, your mentor is not capable of doing any technical task, reach out to us through the GitHub discussion only and let us know if you what kind of person you're looking for or something. But we want to provide a platform for everyone to learn and scale up each other. So just don't remove them, because they can help you in managing a lot of redundant tasks like assigning the issues and managing the decorum of your repositories and finding a good solution for you. So yeah, things can be happens from any scale and any level of people. So I hope this video was helpful for you. So any queries regarding the important dates or any of the information like this, always come to here and try to understand what are we trying to do and what is the responsibility of mentors and project admins, like that. And make sure that if you are providing any swags or perks to the contributors, let us know, so we can also help you to promote your particular repository to the more users. So that's what we are trying to do over here. And also, yeah, try to reward your mentor, try to sponsor them if you can. I do sponsor all of my mentors and few of the best contributors in my repositories, and go through this particular video session. Thank you.